Morning students, I welcome you all for another lecture on the course Computer Architecture and Organization. In today's class, I would like to discuss about the concept basic input-output operations. So this concept completely deals about how we are accessing our data from an input device and how the accessed data was displayed on the output device. So for this simple operation, what are the different small operations are performed internal to the computer system and how our processor accesses the data from an input device and how it can send the same data to an output device to display the data. Fine. All these things we are going to discuss in this concept. Fine. Right. So the input and output operations are essential and the way they are performed can have a significant effect on the performance of a computer. I repeat once again, the input and output operations are essential and these operations are influence the performance of a computer. So how the input and output operations influence the performance of a computer system. We know that the performance of a computer is nothing but the speed of operation of a computer. We know that the speed of operation of the computer is depends on mainly three important things. Number one, that is the hardware which is present in the system. And second one is the machine instructions. And third one, the system software. We know that. In the system hardware, input and output device are the part of it. So no doubt, the input and output operations influence the speed of operation of the system. And these are very, very important to us because with the help of these input and output devices only, the user can communicate with the computer system. That means whenever the user wants to send something to the computer system, then he took the help of an input devices like a keyboard, mouse, joystick, etc. And similarly, if the user want to access something from a system, then user took the help of an output devices like a monitor, printer, all these things. Fine. So input and output operations are very, very important in the computer system. There is no doubt at all. At the same time, the way those operations are performed within the system influence the speed of operation of the computer system itself. Fine. The second one, there is a speed difference exists within the system. That means if you are observing the speed of operation of the processor is very, very high compared to the speed of operation of I/O devices. That means we know that we have so many I/O devices we are using in our system. All those devices' speeds are completely different and their logics are different. And one thing is all those device speeds are very, very less compared to processors. So here what we need, if I want to transfer the data from an I/O device to a processor, definitely I need a synchronizing mechanism. That means I need some interfacing between a processor and this I/O devices. So that we have to remember, guys. So now I would like to show the diagram how the data was transferred between a processor and input and output devices. You know that to transfer a data between a processor and I/O devices, definitely we need a bus. We know that bus is nothing but a group of bytes or bunch of bytes which carries the information which is in physical form. Whenever my processor want to access some data from an input device of keyboard, how it can access it? Whatever data it will want access from this keyboard, the data first it will be stored on data in register. Later the data is transferred to the processor itself. And once the data was stored on the processor register, then the same data is sent to an output device which is a display device. In that process, the processor sending data, first it was copied onto data out register, which is present on output device. So this particular operation, how is going on? Let's we can try to identify that. So whenever if I press any key on the keyboard, what happens is its equivalent 8-bit code was generated internally. The generated code was straight away copied onto the keyboard internal 8-bit buffer register, which we can call as data in register. I repeat, if I press any key over keyboard, internally 8-bit equivalent code was generated. The generated 8-bit code was initially copied onto internal 8-bit register of our keyboard, which we can call as 8-bit buffer register. It can hold that data. That register we can call as data in register. See here, pressing a key on the keyboard does not automatically display on the screen. That's the important thing. If I press something on the keyboard, it is not directly displayed over a keyboard. If you see our system, we think that straight away if I press some key or a keyboard, that corresponding information is displayed on a display. That is not straight away happens. So many internal operations are going on. When we are pressing any key on the keyboard, the same data is displayed on a display device. So here, my statement is like this. If I press any key over a keyboard, that cannot directly display on a display device automatically. Then what happens? A set of instructions in the input-output program transfers a character onto the processor, and another set of instructions are used to transfer the same character to the display device. That's what I'm saying. That means if I go and access a data from an input device, and the same data if I want to display or a display device, definitely I took the help of a input-output program. In that input-output program, a set of instructions are used to transfer the data from an input device to a processor, and another set of instructions are used to display the same data over a display device. So if you remember, guys, it is not happen simply. That means whatever the key we pressed on a keyboard, that can't directly goes to the output device straight away. Meanwhile, so many operations are going on internally. In that process, we took the help of a set of I/O program. What that I/O program can do is, some of the instruction in that I/O program reads the data from an input device, and another set of instructions are used to display the read data information on the display device. Right. So see here, guys, that's what I already told to you. Pressing a key stores the corresponding character code in an 8-bit buffer register, which is called as data in register, which is a present a keyboard. This is a DIN register, not only present in a keyboard, whatever the input device you go and take it in that device, definitely there is a data in register. The job of that data in register is it can hold the information. What are the data we are going to send to the computer system from an input device? So once the data was stored onto this DIN register, internally we have a status flag which I can call as SIN. That is a status flag in bit. This is set to 1. That means internal to your input device, we have a buffer register along with the one of the status register which may have a bit which is called SIN. That is a status in bit. This bit is set to 1 whenever your DIN register is filled with the data in the input device. Then what happens? So see here, our processor I/O program continuously monitoring this CN bit. Because once your DIN register in your input device is filled with the data, that incident only SIN is set to 1. Now here the job of I/O program is, it will continuously monitoring CN. Once a CN bit is set to 1, no doubt DIN register is filled with the data. That incident, your processor can access the data from the input device. So that's why here I written like this: a program monitor CN, and when it is set to 1, the processor reads the content of a DIN register. when the character transfer to the processor, then what happens is automatically our C input is set to a 0. That means your DM register was clear or it was empty. I repeat once again, whenever your processor accessing the data from an input device, it will go and monitor S in bit. If that bit is set to 1, no doubt your processor accesses the data from the input device. That means your processor accesses the data from DM register of that input device. Once the data was successfully transferred to the CPU register, what happens is automatically a SIN, this is the status in bit, is set to a 0. That means SIN is clear. So this is the way how the data was transferring from an input device to the processor. And similarly, what happens? Once the data was transferring from processor into the output device, in the same way, but it was somewhat different. Let me try to find. So the analogous process, that means the similar process, takes place when the characters are transferred from the processor to the display. That means what are the operation you have done once you are reading the data from an input device by your processor, in a similar way the data was transferring from processor register to an output device. Your processors transfer the data to an output device only when in the S out bit, that is the status bit of an output device, which is always present in internal status register of an output device, that is set to 1, that indicates our output device is ready to accept the data from the processor. It means here also our processor monitors S out bit in an output device. Whenever that bit is set to 1, then the processor transfers the data to an output device. Once the processor transfers the data to an output device, our output device receives the data and it was copied onto the data out register. Again, it is another 8-bit internal buffer register of an output device. So here that's what I'm saying. So the processor displays, transferred from the processor to the display, a buffer register data out and a status flag S out are used. When S out equals to 1, that's what I'm saying, S out equals to 1, the display device or an output device is ready to receive the character from processor. That's what I'm saying. So whenever we are receiving the data from an input device by your processor, the processor monitors CN bit. If CN bit is set to 1, then the processors collect the data from an input device, which is already the data was present in DM register of that input device. In a similar way, whenever the processor wants to send the data to an output device, it will want to verify C out bit, that C out bit is set to 1. That means our output device is ready to receive our data from the processor. Then your processor transfers the data. Then the processor sending the data was stored onto data out register of an output device. So for this, how we can make an application program? We can go and try to check it. So here one more thing before discussing about those instructions which are needed to do a reading a character from an input device and displaying character on an output device. The first thing is the reading a data and the writing a data on an output device, this entire process what we can call is program line. But this is one of the technique guys. Generally, the data transfer techniques are three. Out of three data transfer techniques, programmed I/O is one of it. The second one is interrupt-driven I/O. This is the second I/O data transfer scheme. And the third one is DMA. These are two concepts we can learn in next upcoming classes. As of now, you remember, transferring a data between an I/O devices and a processor as well as a memory. So those techniques what we can call is I/O data transfer techniques. In that here we are talking about program level. In this what we are doing, with the help of a set of instructions, we are monitoring a SIN bit as well as we are monitoring a S out bit of input device as well as output device. So that's why it is called as program I/O. Fine. In order to perform I/O transfers, we need a machine instructions that can check the status of status flags. What are the status flags present in our input and output devices? One is SIN, which is a present in input device, and second one is SO, which is a present on output device. That means we need a set of machine instructions to go and check the status of these are two status flags. One is SIN and second one is SO. And later transfer the data between a processor and an I/O device. Don't think guys here I/O device is nothing but input or an output. It is an I/O, that means the device is either input device or it may be an output device. That's the meaning of this. Fine. So next, these instructions are similar in format to those used for moving data between a processor and a memory. Already we have this concept, that is a transferring of data between a memory and a processor. There, what are the instruction formats we are using, or what are the different types of instructions we are using in that particular case? The same type of instructions and the same type of instruction formats are used to transfer the data between an I/O device and a processor. And coming to the next, the processor can monitor the keyboard status flag, which is SIN. Because keyboard is an input device, in the input device we have a status bit that is SIN. And it transfers a character from data in, that is a input buffer register which was present in input device, to the CPU register R1 by the following sequence of instructions or following sequence of operations. Right. So here these are the sequence of operations which are used to read a character from input device. So the first thing is read weight, branch to read weight if C in equal to 0. I can rewrite this. So let you can assume this is read weight, branch to read weight if S in is equal to 0. The meaning of this statement is read weight is nothing but some routine, and which indicates the starting of that particular routine. Branch to read weight, go to this when your SIN is equal to 1. That means your SIN status bit in an input device is equal to 0. That indicates there is no data in register of our input device. So that incident you have to wait. You have to wait until your SIN is equal to 0. Then what happens? If this condition violates, that means your SIN is not equal to 0, that means it is equal to 1, then what happens is input from data into R1. That means that incident, a processor reads the data from an input device to CPU register R1. That was the scenario. In a similar way, how we are going to display data over an output device? So here again the routine name is write weight. This is a routine name. Branch to write weight. It is similar to this. I written like this. Write weight. This is a routine column. Branch to write weight. Right. Sorry, wait, right. Write weight if S out is equal to 0. S out is equal to 0. Write weight, branch to write weight if S out is equal to 0. That means you have to that itself until your S out is equal to 1. If S out is equal to 0, that means there is a not ready condition of your output device to receive our data from the processor. Right? Your SOT is equal to 0, that means your output device is not ready to accept the data from the processor end. If SOT is equal to 1, then and only your output device is ready to access the data from the processor. So that's why I can go and verify SOT bit. If that SOT bit is equal to 0, you have to wait in that position only. Whenever the condition is changing, that means this SOT changes to 1, then output from R1 to data out register. Where we have this data out register, the data out register is an 8-bit buffer register which was present in an output device. Fine. Then, for this same case, for this case, how we are making a machine instruction, that we can go and verify. So, it is a more common to include SIN SOUT device, SOUT SIN as well as, SIN as well as SOUT in a device status register. Let us assume that bit B3, bit B3 in in status register and out status register of some particular I/O device. Here I assume that this C in, that is, sorry, S in, it is a B3 in, it is a B3 in input status register, and this S out is again B3 in or out status register. That was my assumption. So by using this assumption, how I can make a program with the help of machine instructions? That we can go and identify. See here. So first I can go and talk about read the character from an input device. For that case, I written as read wait. Test the bit #3, in status. The meaning of this particular machine instruction is test the bit number B3 in input status register. I repeat once again, test the bit B3 in input status register. What is the meaning of this? Branch is equal to 0. Read wait. That means once if I test B3 that is equal to 0, then branch to again read wait. What is the meaning of that? If my B3 is equal to 0, that means SIN is equal to 0, that means there is no data in register of input device. So once this condition is violated, that means by verifying the bit B3, that means SIN bit is equal to 1, then what happens is move the data byte from data in register to one of the CPU register R1. So that's why here my next machine instruction is move bytes from data in register, which is internally present in an input device, to the CPU register R1. I hope you understand. So here my assumption is, I assuming that SIN is a bit 3 in status register of input device. I verify that bit. If that bit is set to 0, I wait for, again I setting of the same bit is equal to 1. If B3 is set to 1, there is a data that was present in input device internal buffer register. That instant, the data was transferred to CPU register R. Fine. In a similar way, write waits. So that indicates sending a data from processor to an output device. So I use the same type of instruction but a slight modification. That is test bit #3 in status register. It is not in status register, guys. Sorry, this is out status register. That is not in, it is out status register. So here I verify again B3 in out status register, which is here the bit is S out bit. I verify. If the bit is set to 0, write wait. That means branch is equal to 0, write wait. That means my S out is equal to 0. That means my output device is not ready to accept the data. So that's why you have to wait until that S out bit is set to 1. That means my B3 that is set to 1 in an output device, I have to wait. Once B3 is equal to 1, then move byte from CPU register R1 to data out register, which is a part of an output device. I hope you understand how we are accessing our data from an input device and how we are transferring our data to an output device. But in general, we think that this is a very simple operation. If I press some key or keyboard, that's right away displayed on a display device. But internal to that, these many number of operations are going on in our system. It is not a simple operation, guys. It is not a simple. Reading a data from an input device, it is a task. For that case, we are executing a smaller program or a set of instructions we can call as a routine and similar way. Again, we are executing another set of instructions to transfer data from a processor into an output device. It means here our data transfer is like this. This is your input device and this is an output device. In between this, the processor comes onto the picture. That means CPU comes onto the picture. The CPU collects the data from an input device. The collected data was transferred to an output device. This process, what we can call is programmed I/O. That's what I written previous slides. That means with the help of certain program, I collect the data from an input device, and with the help of again a set of program, set of instructions, I transfer the data from processor to an output device. It means here our CPU continuously monitors a SIM bit of this as well as output bit of SOD bit of this. Right? Now, I hope you understand how the input-output operation is going on in the computer system. Right? Thank you for patient listening. Have a nice day.